Make no mistake, the political dogfight for votes in Sydney's western suburbs will be bare-knuckled and it'll be brutal. Five of the Gillard government's most marginal seats are there, and the coalition will be licking its lips at the very prospect of inflicting maximum pain in Labor's heartland. Ellie Southwood joins us from the most marginal seat in the west, the seat of Greenway, which saddles Blacktown. Ellie, the folks there can expect a lot of visiting pollies over the next 8 months, probably bearing gifts.
They certainly can, Sandra, because so many of these seats here in Western Sydney are sitting on a knife edge. This seat of Greenway was won by the government at the last election with a margin of just 0.88%. It's held by Michelle Rowland, and when I called her office this afternoon, her staff were certainly caught by surprise to even hear the election had been called.
These are the people of Western Sydney that are about to become embroiled in an eight-month political war, and it's their votes that will decide the outcome of September's election. And when we told them of the Prime Minister's announcement, most were pleased to hear the election had been called.
I think there's a lot of things going on in politics at the moment, and the people want to have their say.
About time.
Why?
Oh, she wasn't elected to start with.
Western Sydney is traditionally Labor heartland, but come September, that will be under threat because of attitudes like this.
Get rid of Gillard, get rid of her.
Why?
Because she's hopeless. Full stop.
Do you think we need to change our government?
Yes, I do.
But there are others who are sticking with Julia.
So you're a staunch Labor man.
Yeah.
Are you disheartened by what Labor's done?
I wouldn't say disheartened. I'm a little disappointed. I think she's made a few errors or blunders which weren't absolutely necessary to be made.
But you're going to stick with her?
I will, yeah. I think she would be a better Prime Minister than Tony Abbott.
There are 10 key battleground seats in Western Sydney currently held by the government, some by margins of just 1% or less. But if there's an expected 4% swing to the Liberal National Party, half of those will fall to the coalition. Labor MP Laurie Ferguson holds his South West Sydney seat of Werriwa by just over 6%.
Are you worried about losing your seat?
Look, I've been in politics 30 years. To be honest with you, despite the Liberal Party's help to me in their candidate selection for this election, it's a good outcome for me. I think it's going to be the hardest campaign I've ever had in 30 years, but I think I'll hold the seat.
He says key issues for Western Sydney voters will be climate change, road and rail infrastructure, and particularly Sydney's second airport.
Now with me now is the Assistant Treasurer David Bradbury, who holds the Western Sydney seat of Lindsay by just 1.12%. Thank you so much for your time, Assistant Treasurer.
Good to be with you.
Now, your seat, your job is on the line. What is going to make this or break this for Labor out here in Western Sydney at this election?
Well, look, every election is an incredibly tough contest, and this will be one of those. In terms of Western Sydney, I think the issues that will be most important to people are issues that will be important to people all around the country. It'll be about jobs, it'll be about the cost of living, and it'll be about making sure that we are able to build a strong economy for the future. When it comes to jobs, we've created over 800,000 jobs in the time we've been in office. When it comes to cost of living, put in place a range of family supports, many of which, take the school kids bonus that families are receiving today, will be ripped away under the coalition. And when we look at the future, it's our investments in education, rolling out the national broadband network, and making sure that as a country we can take advantage of the opportunities of the growth that's occurring in our region. These are the things that I think will be important to families in our region.
Well, good luck, David Bradbury, and thank you for your time.
Great to be with you.
Sandra.
Ellie Southwood with the Assistant Treasurer there. Thank you.